By the power bestowed upon me by the sixth grade class, I hereby call the 2018 Sunderland Elementary School commencement ceremony to order.
Thank you, Mason. Good evening, families, friends, community members, Superintendent Carey, and the wonderful teaching staff at Sunderland Elementary School. It is with great pleasure that I welcome all of you to the 2018 Sunderland Elementary School 6th grade graduation ceremony. This is a truly beautiful evening, as it not only allows us to honor our graduates, but it gives each and every one of us the opportunity, who have played a significant role in shaping the lives of these students, a chance to reflect upon how much these students have grown in all areas of their lives. Our 6th grade graduates were born in 2005-2006. Here's an interesting fact. In both of those years, Emma and Aiden were the most popular girls' and boys' names, respectively. Sunderland proudly bucked that trend with Emma. However, we do have an Aiden who was unable to attend graduation tonight, and just like the rest of the graduates, we wish him the best of luck. Besides today's graduates joining the world, what other momentous events took place in 2005 and 2006? Well, in 2005, a group of friends wanted to create a platform that would allow people to share videos online. A few of you may have heard of it, as it's just starting to gain popularity, YouTube. And as we all know, there are certain events that take place throughout the course of our lives where we remember exactly where we were and what we were doing, when that event occurred. In 2006, we experienced one of those events. Who among us doesn't remember where we heard the big news of 2006? The planet Pluto was a victim of downsizing, as it was downgraded to a dwarf planet. Memorable. But certainly as important as those events are those of the last 7 years. Graduates, what will you remember from your time here at Sunderland Elementary School? Do you remember coming here for the first time and thinking how big the school is and how big those sixth graders were? Parents, you too. Remember your feeling on your child's first day of school? Excitement, concern, relief, maybe a sense of freedom? But now you are the big kids. You know the school inside and out? And how small do those kindergartners look? And you are the proud parents, grandparents, brothers, sisters, and other friends and family of this truly special group of sixth grade students. You all have accomplished so much here. You've learned to read and write and do math, design roller coasters, and even play Gaga ball. You've made friends that will last you for the rest of your lives. You are experts in the use of technology, like YouTube. You've memorized the names of 9, make that 8 planets. You've excelled in the classroom. You are all ready to move on to Frontier Middle School or whatever your next stop in your next educational journey may be. You are ready because you've worked so hard, but you are also ready because of the love and support from your families. Have you thanked them recently, graduates? Let's give your families a round of applause. And we also have your teachers to thank for teaching you all so much. The teachers at Sunderland are very special. They do so much for each and every student, and I am fortunate to be a part of them. Could I ask all the Sunderland teachers to please stand? So graduates and guests, how about a round of applause for our teachers? It's been wonderful having all of you here at SES. Believe me, you will always remember your time, even as you accomplish so much more in the years ahead. Each and every one of you will be successful, and your teachers and I will look forward to hearing about those accomplishments in the years to come. Speaking of accomplishments, isn't there a big birthday party coming up? Yes, we are about to celebrate the town of Sunderland's 300th anniversary. As I had alluded to earlier, this celebration will, without a doubt, be one of those events in your lives that you will forever remember. And how cool is it to say that you were the graduating sixth grade class the year your hometown celebrated its 300th anniversary. Each year, one of the final assignments for our sixth graders is for them to reflect upon their years here at Sunderland and think of some of their fondest memories. In keeping with this tradition, I would like to read a few. I remember in second grade when we had Willy Wonka Day and Miss Wortley dressed up as Willy Wonka. I remember earning scholar dollars for bringing in my homework in Miss Carmody's fourth grade class, and I got to buy something. I remember going to the Loop Zoo in kindergarten. I remember Mr. Copeland sidetracking every day and telling us about something about that he heard on NPR earlier that morning. I remember when we had Inaction Day every year. I remember in first grade when Mrs. Wells read Charlotte's Web to the class. I remember in third grade when I went to Plymouth Plantation and had lots of fun. I remember throwing fake tea over the side of the ship at the Boston Tea Party Museum. I remember saying goodbye to my friends, and they would say, "Goodbye, Jacob," and I would say, "Goodbye, friends." Sixth graders, it is quite clear the memories you have of Sunderland Elementary School are just the beginning of many great things to come. And now I would like to introduce our guest speaker. Stephen Wortley was a member of the Sunderland class in 2012, and he just graduated from Frontier Regional School earlier this June. While at Frontier, Stephen was the captain of the football team, and he was also a member of the wrestling and baseball teams. His favorite course of studies was U.S. history. At graduation this year, he was a recipient of the Tim Merritt Memorial Scholarship. In the fall, Stephen plans to attend Westfield State University and begin his pursuit of a degree in criminal justice, where he would eventually like to work as a state trooper. Additionally, Stephen's mother, Lee, has been a longtime classroom teacher here at SES. On behalf of the Sunderland Elementary School community, please help me in welcoming Stephen Worthley as this year's guest.
Well, hello, graduates. How's it feel? Pretty sweet, right? I just want to start this speech off by congratulating all of you on the accomplishment of completing elementary school and starting a journey on the path to achieve a higher education. Just like all of you, I graduated here 6 years ago in 2012. I remember taking that last stroll through the playground, reminiscing on the fun times and the friendships I made in this building. I remember walking through this gymnasium and seeing my family and friends coming out to support the accomplishments that you today and over the years here have made. I'm sure that most of you are going to continue your path through Frontier and will be attending seventh grade there after this summer, just like I did. This is a huge step for all of you. The responsibilities, freedoms, and opportunities you will have in seventh grade are truly a one-of-a-kind experience. Whether you're interested in sports, musicals, robotics, technology, or science, there's a number of clubs at Frontier, and they can all offer this to you. There's a home for you there. The opportunities that you'll get to take part in are truly incredible, and it's an amazing privilege. Take me, for example. I started playing football, baseball, and basketball my first year in seventh grade. After experiencing with wrestling and baseball for a little longer, I finally decided that my heart was on the football field. This is just an example of what all of you are capable of. You will each discover a passion of yours, and you will be able to pursue it at Frontier. One thing I want to leave you with tonight is the friendships that you have made here and will make in the future. I have had the opportunity to meet the most incredible people in this world through middle and high school, and I am honored to call them my friends. The friendships you have made here will last you forever, and the people you will get to meet will make your experiences so much better in the future. Do not forget about the people who have shaped you into who you are and who have cared for you as you all continue your journey outside these walls. So, sixth grade class, I want to say congratulations, have fun, enjoy these last moments together as a class, and never forget it. And always remember that with love that this school has taught you, anything is possible for you.
Thank you, Stephen. Wonderful job. It is now time for the presentation of class gifts and acknowledgments. Will the class gift presenters, Kelsey Bowell and Janelle Rodriguez, please come up to the stage?
Busy this year fundraising. Their efforts helped raise money to offset the cost of our class trip to Morse Hill and graduation expenses. We thank all of you for making this possible. Our trip to Morse Hill was fantastic. During the school year, with help from the Hitchcock Center, many classes were involved planning and designing some mock rainwater catchment systems. Grade 6 was fortunate to go to the Hitchcock Center to better understand their water catchment systems as well as other systems.
Sunderland Elementary School is planning on building their own water catchment system, whose goal will be to capture rainwater to use in the vegetable garden. Our plan is to donate all of our remaining funds to help make this engineering project happen. Thanks to everyone, especially my parents, and once again, thank you PTO for all you do for our school committee.
Thank you, Kelsey and Janelle. We will now have a special presentation. Will Iris Hill and Sukhmanpreet Singh please come to the stage?
All of us in grade 6 were happy to welcome a new student to our class. He came to us in January, all the way from Shenyang, China, which is over 10,501 kilometers or approximately 6,525 miles away. Aiding Lee has enriched our classroom in so many ways.
He has taught us so much, different ways to do math, cool science experiments, and much more. He's always in a good mood and is always making us smile. He was so brave to enter a new school and a new country and new kids.
We hope that we made him feel welcome, and we wish him success in the days to come.
Eric, would you please come up to the stage for a special gift from all of us?
At this time, can Joshua Dion and Julia Wachowitz please come up to the stage?
Mr. Copeland, Ms. O'Brien, and Ms. Von Planet.
It has truly been a pleasure and an honor being taught by you. It feels as though it was only yesterday when you first met me, even though it has been over 9 months.
You not only have taught us math, science, and English, but also how to be kind, brave, curious, and how to equally balance learning with fun. These are skills we will take with us forever.
We are truly thankful that you have been a part of our lives, and we will always remember you in the school.
Thank you.
Will Mr. Copeland, Ms. O'Brien, Ms. Montclair please come to the stage? This year, many of our sixth grade students have participated and supported school experiences by volunteering in the capacity of student ambassador. Student ambassadors help out by providing assistance at International Night, Family Fun Night, and within school-based experiences of giving tours to new students and families, face painting at the carnival, and offering their care for our school. These very important opportunities demonstrate community service and build leadership skills. We appreciate and thank you. Please stand in recognition if you have served in the capacity of student ambassador this year. Thank you. During the 2015-2016 school year, our community lost one of our parents, Daniela Zinn, who passed away after a long battle with cancer. Daniela was the mom of Feline and Owen, who are finishing up their fourth and eighth grade years respectively. Daniela was an amazing individual who committed her life towards helping those in need, such as helping the mentally ill and those with eating disorders. Additionally, Daniela volunteered in Haiti on several occasions. This led to the adoption of her daughter, Feline. In honor of Daniela's Inn, her family will make an annual gift of $1,000 to Sunderland Elementary School in her name. They would also like to recognize a young person who exhibits Daniela's qualities. To be considered for this recognition, the recipient should possess a combination of the following: an outstanding academic record and personal experience with engagement and leadership on issues of equality, diversity, cultural awareness, and global affairs. The recipient of this award will receive a plaque provided by Daniela's family. It is with great pleasure that I announce this year's recipient, Julia Walkowitz. I will now present the Principal's Awards, which is given annually to those students who have shown excellence in their perseverance, attitude, willingness to help others, and serving as a role model for all students. The awards this year go to Caroline Dean and Thelonious Sargent. At this time, we will now present certificates to our graduating sixth grade students. Will row one please come up to the stage? Kelsey Boutwell. Alex Carey. Jack Carey. Ethan Coombs. Tyler Cousin. Caroline Dean. Joshua Dion. Hunter Everett. Cole Fabry. Wyatt Finch. Robert Fuque. Iris Hill. Riley Holberg. Eden Lee. Will row two, please come up to the stage. Unable to join us tonight, Andrew O'Sullivan. Christopher Penza. Tenzin Pelge. River Roderick. Janelle Rodriguez. Hunter Russell. Benjamin Zachary. Thelonious Sargent. Sukhmanpreet Singh. Chanji Sun. Julia Walkowitz. Unable to join us tonight, Aiden Sutton. Kaizik Yap. Jacob Ward. I would like to present to you the Sunderland Elementary School Class of 2018. Way up to the stage for pictures. performance by the Sunderland Elementary School 6th grade class under the direction of our music teacher, Ms. Sue Matsui. Our 6th graders will sing "Thank You for Being a Friend" by Andrew Gold. We will now view the 6th grade slideshow, which was put together by Michelle Russell. Thank you for your patience as we prepare this wonderful photographic memory. Would the chorus please exit the stage? Excellent job.
The days come easy and the moments pass slow, and each road leads you where you wanna go. And if you're faced with a choice and you have to choose, I hope you choose the one that means the most to you. And if one door opens to another door closed, I hope you keep on walking till you find the window. If it's cold outside, show the world the warmth of your smile. But more than anything, more than anything, my wish for you is that this life becomes all that you want it to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you but you never forget all the ones who love you and the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take, but more than anything. Yeah, more than anything. My wish for you is that this life becomes all that you wanted to. Your dreams stay big, your worries stay small. You never need to carry more than you can hold. And while you're out there getting where you're getting to, I hope you know somebody loves you and wants the same things too. Yeah, this is my. But you never forget all the ones who love you and the place you left. I hope you always forgive and you never regret, and you help somebody every chance you get. Oh, you find God's grace in every mistake, and always give more than you take, but more than anything. Yeah, more than anything. My wish for you, the way.
Because I'm happy.
Clap along if you feel like a room without a roof.
Because I'm happy.
Clap along if you feel like happiness is the truth.
Because I'm happy.
Clap along if you know what happiness is to you.
Because I'm happy.
Clap along if you feel like that's what you want to do.
Graduation.